Welcome to Kman Energy. The Kman Energy series of videos will be all about batteries, different batteries, building battery packs, and exploring existing batteries. I have the option to get lots and lots of batteries from different sources, used, new, all around. So I thought, let's start with some more unusual ones. So today, I have this 45 volt, number 455 style battery. It was manufactured by Eveready. And despite the relatively ancient style looking case, this is actually only a couple years old, maybe 2 or 3 years old. Now this one was pulled from a piece of medical monitoring equipment. However, these batteries are actually common both for, well, it's an alkaline. It's common for medical devices, testers, meters. Most commonly used in telecom KS8455 meters for telephone installers and repairmen, and those were analog meters. And this one actually is holding, I haven't opened it yet, the bottom is open, but I have not looked inside yet. But this one's actually putting out 47.9 volts on my super accurate Harbor Freight free after coupon multimeter. So it's obviously going to be, since it's an alkaline, a pile battery. So let's just take a little look here. I also have Eveready's product data sheet. And let's just take a little peek. It's got the physical dimensions. Design, let's see. Battery voltage nominal is 45 volts, 8.2 ounces or 231 grams. Average capacity 550 milliamp hours, 2.8 volts a cell, rated at 25 milliamp continuous drain. So even though it was a high voltage battery, the ideal drain was actually relatively low drain. And it says it has 30 number 130 cells in a series with a paper jacket. You can see the discharge rate here. And let's zoom in on the discharge, and that should get a little better here. Schedule 4 hours a day. Typical drain at 36 volts was 0.8 milliamps. So 45,000 ohm load. And it looks like it's got quite a number of service hours on there. Now, because this was in medical equipment, it had to be replaced due to sticky zooming button. It had to be replaced due to age rather than actual being used up or exhausted. Can't have medical equipment biting. Whoops! Oh, good thing that's not lithium. Can't have medical equipment biting the dust on people. And here is an example of one of the telecom meters that this battery style is installed in, which is the KS8455. This one's the L2 analog meter. That was the best picture I can get for purposes of this video. And of course, now what you've all been waiting for. Let's see, hopefully there's nothing leaked, but considering that's still putting out really good voltage. And there you go. Just a simple cardboard box shell. And it actually, if you notice, it looks like a 9-volt battery style terminals on the top. I've got one of those over here. Got a little collection of 9 volts going. But as you can see, compared to a 9-volt, it's quite a big size difference. And the terminals are of different physical size. The 9-volt battery terminals are slightly smaller. Okay, that didn't work out planned. So, of course, alkaline batteries have a voltage of approximately, or full voltage of approximately 1.5 volts per cell. And we're going to zoom in on the battery now. Give it a better look for you. So at 1.5 volts per cell, to get to the nominal of 45 volts, you know, it says 30 cells. So let's just take handy dandy calculator. 30 times 1.5, which would bring us to 45 volts. And considering it's putting out slightly, now some alkalines, I mean, ideally 1.5 volts is what a fully charged alkaline cell will give you. In fact, a 9 volt battery has, let's see, it'd be 6 cells. There's 6 mini alkaline cells inside a 9-volt battery. We'll be opening one of those up in a different video, because a lot of people don't know that. And that's how they create 9 volts. So 6 times 1.5 is 9 volts. Some alkaline cells are actually 1.6 volts, so we multiply that by 30. And wouldn't you know, that gives us 48, which is what the current voltage is of this battery. So despite it already being used in medical equipment or a meter, it still is holding a awesome charge. And you can see they have 30 individually wrapped cells inside this pack. Now this would be what is called a pile battery. A pile because, just like it looks like, the cells are piled on top of each other. Or pile is also another way of saying that there is more than one cell in a battery. Now, likewise, you got yourself, zoom out now, in case you missed it, here's the top terminals with a piece of plastic. And those are, I got a little piece of cardboard glued on there, very cheap construction. And it does not appear to be leaking. The top seems to have some sort of wax seal. And it's just got some tabs soldered, not even welded, but just soldered on the top. But another type of pile battery, so you got hoverboard batteries. What's inside a hoverboard? 18650 lithium cells, which were, once again, it's going to be in another video. But you have 20 18650 cells in the random Chinese hair in a hoverboard battery. And since those are connected in a series, it is also considered a pile battery. So that is it for today. The next video in this series will be, we'll be going over one of those hoverboard batteries, the internals, and going over how it maintains lithium cells. So I started with the unusual, something that's not seen too often, which is a 45-volt alkaline battery. And likewise, you could also see this style battery in carbon zinc. So basically any battery that is called heavy duty or super heavy duty is going to be a carbon zinc battery. What is a carbon zinc battery? Well, a carbon zinc battery is where the casing of the battery, so, okay, that wasn't a battery. I just grabbed something I thought was a battery and it turned out to be lip balm, Carmex. So let's take... Now, this is actually a lithium cell, but this is the same size as a AA battery. So, pretend it is a normal AA battery. On an alkaline, the anode, cathode, everything's contained inside the metal can. On a carbon zinc battery, the actual casing is made out of zinc and can be, and it is actually sacrificed. If you ever gave one a squeeze, a carbon zinc one, you'll notice you can easily dent the carbon zinc can. Inside, it's got the electrolytes and carbon inside, and generates power just like an alkaline battery does, and still has the same voltages as a standard alkaline battery. However, they do not hold the same capacity. Usually you can see, I've seen alkaline 1.5 volt alkaline AA batteries go as high as about 2 or 2.5 amp hours capacity, whereas a carbon zinc you're generally going to be finding between 500 and 600 milliamp hours. We got industrial alkaline. Another big difference is going to be weight. And then you got a carbon zinc. And that one's super heavy duty. So, you know what? Let's just get our scale out here so I can show the difference. Switch to grams. Carbon zinc. Oh my gosh, why is everything dinging? I can't see that. 3.3 grams for the carbon zinc. Oh, come on, people, with the dinging. I shut the ringer up on the phone, and then the watch starts dinging. Let's switch over to the alkaline is 4.6 grams. So the alkaline is quite a bit more energy dense, but they also cost more. As comparison, 1.2 ounces or 1.7 ounces. So 7.5 ounces or 212 grams. So that concludes today's battery exploration video.
Smile, cheese.